Hello viewer, welcome to Artistry. I am Tirus Wanyoike, your presenter. So we are in the woodwork trade where we have quite a number of tools ahead of me. I have some glue, I have a plane, and they want us to learn something to do with joining wood. Joining wood using wood glue. We have previously learned about joining wood using fixing devices like the screws, the nails, and so on. So today we are going to learn something to do with joining wood using glue. So glue, we have two samples of glue here, and we are not limited to this. Glues are so diverse, they are so different depending on the nature of job and the process it is taken through and the time and duration that we needed to take, and the nature of work, because there are marine glues, there are glues for outside structures, we still have glue for indoor structures, and so forth and so forth. Some glue is water-based, like this one. We call it the polyvinyl acetate, PVA glue. It is water-based, it is white in color. As you can see the bottle, this is the normal water bottle. We have put some glue in it. Then we have this other glue that we call the moisture curing glue. In normal essence, wood is supposed to be used when it is dry, it is seasoned, it will have acceptable, we talk of acceptable moisture content, but in case you're using wood that has not achieved the acceptable moisture content, that means it is still seasoning, this is the most appropriate glue, because it has a provision for that, it will get along with that. So the forms kind of a foam once it cures, and then it will have a very strong bond. Once you apply it, after a while, you see some foam forming out of the joint, and then the bond there will be very tight. So that is a moisture glue, as we call it. The brand name is Fevico. So for a bottle like this, it goes for plus or minus 1,000 shillings, but for this one, might be cheaper. This might be 200 to 300 shillings. So that is the difference between the two. So this one takes a bit longer to cure. So in good weather, especially in the warm weather, it will take about 6 hours. It might take longer if there is no good weather. So sometimes we even let it go overnight, so that by tomorrow we are sure it has cured well. It is well dry. So these are the two types of glue that we have today. So we're going just to use one of them. Perhaps we can use the polyvinyl acetate PVA glue. And then it is common, it is cheap, it is affordable. It is nice, it forms a very good bond. It is also water-based, so it will penetrate more into the wood pores than any other glue, according to my observation. So we have pieces of wood here. Here we have a piece of block board. We defined these manufactured boards. As you can see from the cross section, here, we see the block board is made of various strips of wood, various pieces of wood. As you can see, the end grains. What we see here are the end grains to the various pieces of wood that has been used. And then on every side, we have a plywood, a kind of a structured plywood fitted on both sides of the board. So that forms the block board. So the block board is normally a manufactured board that you buy ready. So what matters and varies is the thickness. The thickness here is what varies. They normally consider it in inches. So you'll see someone telling the man in the hardware, give me a 3/4 block board. Block board here 3/4. I'm a block board here 1. 1 denoting 1 inch, arm and a half. Those are the most common types of blockboard. So this is a blockboard I'm going to use to demonstrate the lamination, but in itself it has the lamination because these are various pieces of wood which are different, and then they have been glued to each other, and then the plywood is glued again on this. The plywood is again glued on this side so that it forms the board. So it is one of the stable boards that we have because it doesn't have any filler materials inside. It's purely strips of wood and plywood and glue. So glue is quite strong because this blockboard will never come out. It will never come in pieces except subjected under moist conditions or some other unfavorable conditions. That is why it can tear off because the glue used is water-based in many cases. So once it's subjected back to moisture and to wetness, of course it will start succumbing to that effect, the water effect. So in itself, we have seen an example of lamination. Lamination meaning putting pieces of wood together to form a wide board. And beside me here, I also have another laminated board. It is used to form a door lining. It's a lining of a door. The thickness of the wall is about 280 millimeters, slightly less than 1 foot, and we have various strips of wood laminated together, and then they have been thicknessed using the machine, and then once we sand the surface, it becomes very smooth. You cannot notice that there were different parts of wood, pieces of wood put together. So the concept of lamination comes out in very many areas in joinery. If you want to be good in producing joinery items, you have to do good lamination using good wood glue, and also know that if need be, you must laminate pieces that are not well seasoned, then you consider using the moisture glue. It's good to have that information so that once you have some work that is required to be done very fast and you don't have the time to get seasoned wood, then you know you have an alternative. You can also use it on dry wood, there is no problem. So it can fit both purposes, but it's a bit expensive as compared to the other ordinary PVA glue that we have. Now, pieces of wood, pieces that are going to form the beading or the finishing to the board. If you look at the raw edge of the board, we call it the raw edge. It cannot remain like this because it is too raw. It looks unfinished. It's not decent. You can't say we have finished work when the board is like this. In many boards, you'll see it is well finished on all edges. So to achieve that, we use such a beading. We laminate or put glue and clamp it, and then we give it time. After it has cured, then we remove it. We do the finishing on it. Then from there, we can say we have a nice piece of board for a door or something like that. So what I want to laminate right now, I want to use it for the door to this cabinet here that you see. So this cabinet will have a door very soon when we make it with you. And we are soon going to start. So these long pieces of metal, they are known as the sash clamp. We previously dealt with the F clamp. F clamp denotes the letter F. Now we have this tool here. This one we call it the sash clamp. It has a screw at the end, so it will either reverse or press forward. It has a shoe. The shoe is this part that moves backward and forward. And there are various holes here that we use the pin, the metal pin, to hold the shoe in place there. And then the piece of work will be here. And then we clamp it from here. It gives a very tight grip inside there. So for me to achieve a good, well-pressed door, I'll need to laminate or to glue my two pieces to the ends of the blockboard, and then I'll press against each other with the clamp. So the clamps are ready. I have set them well, and I'm now ready for action. So what remains now, you make sure you plane your beading. We call it the beading or the piece that you're going to fix there. You plane it well, it fits well, no gaps remaining. And then once you are ready to go, remove the beading, apply glue. Now glue, I've put it in this bottle so that I can be able to spread with the same bottle. I don't have to use my hands. So the white glue will be used on the glue on the strip that I'm going to laminate. I'll spread it well that way, and then I'll put it there. Then I'll come remove the other piece here, apply glue on it. Just a thin layer of glue will work. People may think the more glue you put, the more tight it will be. But the glue line is very thin. Very thin. So with that, now I'm okay. I'm okay with that. The two pieces have been glued. The clamps are in place. So I'll introduce a third clamp up here. I have this clamp here. I'll put it on top so that I can make sure the pressure. Once I start clamping this way, there is a bit of pressure because the metal bar is on the lower side. There will be some pressure pushing it up. So if I'm not careful and I just screw and tighten, this project may just explode up because all pressure is trying to push it up. So there are two solutions to that. I may look for some small wedges and I put them between the shoe and this beading on the upper half of this beading. The upper half of this beading, I put a small packing or some wedge, and also here and here and here. That way, the pressure will start now from the wedge going down. So it will press against the clamp and I'll be safe. If I don't have the third clamp, that's an option that I can use. Now, since I have the third clamp, what I do, I provide a base for it. Sorry. I provide a base for it so that it can rest there. Then I pull out the pin, push the shoe backwards, and then I overturn my clamp there. I fit the shoe well with the pin. We call it the pin, that metal piece that is holding the shoe in place. The pin. Without the pin, you cannot achieve what you want. So I'll put it there. Now it will provide opposite pressure. Now it will pressurize it downwards. So I'll start with it because downwards it cannot move anymore. So we applied glue, now we are clamping. I clamp a little bit there, and then I tighten these other ones just a little bit, bit by bit. I go about it, bit by bit. I may do it easily here, but the pressure exerted there is so much pressure. So with that little pressure that I've put, I'm good to go. Now my clamping is over. It's that simple. Now I have put beading on this piece of blockboard on both sides. Now after it has cured, I'll just take my plane and then I'll plane this difference. The difference between here and here. I'll plane it carefully, and then on the other side as well, I trim the ends. And then I sand it, sandpaper, sanding. I sand it and then my door will look nice and I'll be able to fit it in the cabinet. So that is an example, and I'll wait for the board to cure. So the next lesson, perhaps we will use the board with the beading, and we'll see how good it is to work with a good finished board. So the lamination process. The lamination process is used in very many concepts. For this one, I have used it now to laminate, or rather to put beading on the doors of this small cabinet. I'm intending to use it for first aid purposes. I will be using, keeping some Dettol, some antiseptic, Dettol and the like, some first aid items on it. It is small, so I'm going to hang it somewhere on the wall and be using it for first aid. Now, another application for that, for lamination also, is the piece of item I have here. I have called it a chapati board. Chapati board, of course, we all know chapatis. We celebrate a lot of them during festivities and when we have guests and all this. Now, for you to make good chapatis, of course, you need good preparation for them. Now, the chapati board is available now for use even on the table. You can place it on the table, and then soon after, you can hang it simply on the wall. You can also opt to put some stand on it. Now, assuming my stool here doesn't have a top, I can use now the stand for the chapati board. Although the stand for this tool is a bit bigger. Now, if I structure a chapati board frame, and then that on top, instead of the square top, I put the chapati board on top, then it becomes one which can work without being put on the table. So it depends with what you want. If I just put a frame on it, it will become as good as this tool, and then we don't varnish the chapati board, simply because it's coming into contact with food, and these finishes are chemical in nature, so we don't want to contaminate food. So for chapati board, we use just a natural salad oil. We smear it on the chapati board, and it will resist water to a good degree. So the point here was that these boards are about 1, 2, 3. These are three boards that have been laminated. You can see how well they get into each other. They cannot now separate because they have been carefully glued. You see the kind of bond that forms here. It's the same bond that will form here. So even after finishing this item, it should look as good as this. It will just look like one piece has been put together. So laminating is a concept in woodwork and in carpentry and joinery. And every joiner must know the simple basics of lamination, because every time you're using blockboard, you cannot leave it on with a raw edge. So you have to finish the edge and make sure that it will be user friendly, it will be protected from the conditions around where it is going to be used. So this concept takes the joiner a short time if you are prepared and you have the right tools to do it. With the sash clamps, they are very good in the lamination process. But nowadays we have machines that have come now which are automated, and they are used for that purpose. We also have glue that is curing very fast. Now, with a good machine that has a hydraulic press, and then it has a fast curing glue, the glue might take just about 1 or 2 minutes, and then the beading is tightly fixed, and then from there you can do so many units in a day. So it is important to know the developing concepts that are coming up. But now for this glue, you may have to wait for a whole 6 hours, 8 hours or so, depending on the weather. But now if you can fasten that process, then you can have more production per day. So that is a simple process of lamination. We have done it practically. Now, after curing, we shall remove the clamps, we shall finish with the plane, and then we shall be good to go. We shall fit our door. We shall use Malfa hinges to fit it, and then we shall have our item ready for use. So for now, we'll take a break, and then we will be back. So stay tuned.